torsional pendulum. There are different types of suspension device: copper, brass, bronze, cast iron, and zinc. Let us select cast iron. So let us hang two identical mass positions at a distance of d2. So you get these d2 masses. Let us raise that mass from 5 grams to 10 grams. Okay. Then let us select the disc mass. The laboratory disc is having 1178 grams. So approximately let us go for 1.2 kilograms. Disc radius. Radius is around 6 centimeters. Suspension wire length. So the length between this chuck nut and this suspension wire, that means the torsional pendulum, let us keep as 35-40 centimeters first. Okay, then radius of the wire as 0.07 centimeters. Now after fixing all these variables, so the length between the chuck nut and this is 40 centimeters. So now rotate this disc of the torsional pendulum by a small angle. So it is going to rotate. So time period will calculate. So this is the starting position. From here to the other end it will go and will come back. So that will calculate as one oscillation. So let us start the reading. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So for 20 oscillations it has taken 31.67. How much is the time taken for 20 oscillations? 31.67. And stop this. And this other thing we are going to do now is we will do the trial 2 for the same length. Okay, once again start the time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So in this case earlierly what is that? 31.67. In the trial 1 we have 31.67. In trial 2 we have 31.71. We will take the average of these two. Similarly, you repeat the experiment for different length of this wire. So from 40 to now we will make it as 50. Again, allow it to rotate, start it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and the last one 20. So in the case of 50 centimeters trial one is 34.95. Let's stop this and do the trial 2. So now again start the timing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So again, what is the reading in trial 2? 34.67. So repeat for three different lengths. So like that we can calculate the time taken to time period. So until now we have time taken for 20 oscillations. Time taken for 20 oscillations divided by 20 will give you time taken for one oscillation. Like that we are able to find out the time period from this experiment. We will demonstrate torsional pendulum. So the operator required for the torsional pendulum is wire, Allen wire, circular disc, stopwatch, vernier calipers, screw gauge, and a meter scale. So with the help of the meter scale, first fix the length between check nut to check nuts. Okay, so now we will fix the length between two check nuts as 50 centimeters. So here we have 0 and here we have 70 centimeters length, still no defect. So the length between two check nuts we are fixing as 40 centimeters first, okay. So the length between the two check nuts is 40 centimeters now. Now rotate this torsional pendulum a small angle 30 degrees. So from this point to the other end, and it will come back to this point, that we will consider as one oscillation. So let us start our stopwatch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and last one 20. So the time taken for 20 oscillations is 55 seconds. So that we should note down. Again, it is length 40 seconds. For the same length, let us repeat for the trial. Okay, this is it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So now this time is
53 seconds. In the trial run, you got 55 and this 53 will take the average of 53 plus 55 by 2. That will give the time taken for 20 oscillations. That which will be divided by 20 will give the time period of this pendulum. After that, by taking vernier calipers, so vernier calipers contains main scale and subscale. So main scale is having 15 centimeters and subscale 10 divisions. So now with the help of this vernier calipers, we would like to calculate the diameter. Half of the diameter will be the radius of the circle. So now we would like to calculate the diameter of this one. So we between these two jars we have fixed our circular disc. Now you can see that the main zero of the vernier is at 11.9, and out of these 10 which is coinciding, that we have to observe here, the third one is coinciding. So 11.9 plus 0.01 into 0.03. So the total diameter of this circular disc becomes 11.93. So half of that 11.93 by 2 will give the radius of that circular disc. Then the other instrument what we have to use is screw gauge. And in the making usage of screw gauge, first of all we should check its error. So in this case the error is above 0 is above means it is negative error. So the error is plus 3 and the correction is minus 3. So above negative, so it is negative, and we have to add plus 3 every time we are going to take the reading. So fix this jaw between these, the wire should be fixed between two jaws, and you can see the pitch scale reading is 0 and head scale coincidence is 95 plus correction 3. So totally 95 plus 3 97. So 97 into least count is 0.001. so total is going to become 0.097. so that we are adding the main scale in 0. So the diameter of this wire is 0.097, so divided by 2 will give its radius. So this is the way how we have to perform. And after getting all these results, we should calculate by using the formula.